Better than 80,000 on hand for the 89th meeting between Iowa and Wisconsin, a series that dates back to 1894. And the highly coveted Heartland Trophy will be up for grabs. Wisconsin opens with a 3-0 lead and first and 10 from their own 11-yard line. And Ogunbowale is stopped in the backfield. Drew Ott, one of the playmakers on that Iowa defense, tackle for the loss.
It's the big man that you need if you're going to run this 3-4 scheme, and really impressive to be just a true freshman. And how about this call here? Conservative, just put three on the board. Not when you're on the road and not when you feel great about your quarterback. This decision is because of the confidence they have in C.J. Beathard.
Iowa 3-for-4 so far this season, going for it on fourth down. Canizari, the back, is split out to the left. Empty backfield. This is 4th and 2. Interesting call. Not there. Michael Caputo had the coverage of a tight end, Henry Krager Coble, and Beathard couldn't hit him. Rafael Gaglianoni.
Thank you.
Good from 46. This from 42 yards away. Hit a 50-yarder against Iowa last year, so we know he has it in him. And no! Not this time. Iowa 3-for-5 so far, converting third downs. Beathard standing at his own 25. No pressure at all. Has time for coffee and lunch. And with all that time, he's intercepted. Picked off by T.J. Edwards. It will go the other way. But there is a flag on the play. There is a flag down. We'll check that.
Could be hands to the face, possibly. Let's take a look here.
Beathard had so much time.
I think he's going to catch a break here.
Personal foul. Hands to the face. Defense number 41. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. Automatic. First down.
It's Jesse Hayes. That's a big penalty.
I think this is the right call. It's awfully close. You're going to see right here Jesse Hayes, the redshirt senior, and it starts at the throat, but it is coming. Ooh, that is awfully, awfully close.
Marshall Kane is on to attempt the 27-yard field goal. And it is no good. No good from 27. Second down and 6. Heel stays in there as the lone setback. Stobby looking to throw the whole way, and he throws it to the wrong team. It's Desmond King. And King is forced out at the 30-yard line. Desmond King, who already led the team with 3 interceptions, comes up with his 4th of the season. 2 interceptions in the Pittsburgh game on the first 2 possessions by the Panthers. So great field possession now for Iowa. Looks like Beathard's changing the play at the line of scrimmage. And checks it away, handoff to Canizari. Has some running room, makes a cut. And he's brought down at the 11-yard line. 19-yard gain. Didn't look like that much was there.
Boy, this is amazing. Look at this clock, this first half. With two teams that love to possess the ball, they run it. Quarterbacks have been fairly efficient other than Stavi's interception. And the chance here with just 3 minutes to go to halftime to really gain some of what coaches always talk about, that critical energy and momentum coming in and out of halftime.
3 tight ends now on first and goal. Off the play action, and he's going to throw it. And it's caught wide open. Was George Kittle for the touchdown. And Iowa's on the board. And that's the first touchdown allowed by Wisconsin now in the last 4 games. Stavi sends the man in motion on first down and 10. Got pressure from the backside, didn't feel it, loose ball. And who's got it? The Iowa bench is going wild. Hawkeyes have the football. And a dramatic turn of events here at Camp Randall Stadium. Be a sure thing. 33-yard attempt for Marshall Kane, who's already missed from 27, but this one is good. With 63 seconds left in the half, 10-3 Iowa. Tipped the ball in the air, nearly leading to the interception. 1 for 5 on third down conversions. Wisconsin needs to pick that up. And Staube tried to drop it in, and it's intercepted. It's Desmond King and his second interception of the game, fifth of the season to take over the Big Ten lead. A win here in Madison, gotta think, puts them into the top 25. Oh, Bethard was rocked, and he's intercepted. Michael Caputo makes up for it. On the interception, Schobert applying the pressure on Bethard. And it's the first turnover of the day, forced by Wisconsin. Badger football.
But just the gain and avoiding the sack actually gives you a chance at 3 points. So a nice job there by Staube, limiting the damage, finding the completion, and setting up our guy, Rafael, up for the field goal.
Gaglianoni, not even going to take a shot at it, huh? He's good from 46. He missed from 42. This from 46 again. To make it a little closer. On the way, and it is good. Rafael Gaglianoni gets it done. It's a 4-point game. Come on, Ewart. That looked really close. I mean, that is really close.
Can you possibly take the risk to QB sneak at your own 26 in a matchup you've not won your last three times? Your last win in the series in this building in 2009. Can you possibly, you did it earlier, the QB sneak down at the goal line.
Did you see Joe Flacco's quarterback sneak the other night?
That was poor.
Wow.
That was a poor effort.
Tom Brady gets it every time. So what, fourth and an inch, maybe two?
And looks like we will have a little review of exactly where that contact was.
Too important of a play. Stephen Beckman is the replay official. And Kirk Ferentz must know what he's going to do already.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands. Fourth down.
And they're going for it.
And you know what, Steve?
Yep, tell me.
Play to win. Play to win.
Fourth and an inch from their own 25 and a half with a 4-point lead.
Push the pile. Right call.
And it is the first down. Bethard looked like he wanted to take a shot there. Now he loses the football. Ball is out. Wisconsin says they have it. And they do. Joe Schobert recovers. TJ Edwards knocking it away from CJ Bethard. How about those two back-to-back plays?
They're setting up an enormous and biggest third down to date.
Ogunbowale Single step back to the right of Stoddy. On third and seven. See if a fourth down decision has to be made here, trailing by four. Stoddy in and out of the hands, and there is a flag. Jazz Peavy looked like he had it and couldn't hang on. Desmond King on the coverage. And that time, King might have been flagged. As the officials huddle.
Ooh, and that is close. He's running the route better than Peavy does. He just has a little bit of contact, and we have seen this today.
See the reaction from King.
Pass interference. Defense number 14.
You can see 71% winning typically football.
First time in the red zone, though, this afternoon. Fumble, loose ball, and it's still out. All sorts of problems with the exchange. Iowa says they have it. You do have all three timeouts remaining, but still. Here's Stoddy. And the pocket collapses around him, and he is dropped at the 40-yard line. Cole Fisher, who had two sacks previous, will add to that total.
No, I don't think so, Steve. I would disagree just because of this right here. They're going to try to force that early throw, and they've hit you and hit you constantly in these downs.
Stoddy, pressure coming late, and lofts it in perfectly to Reggie Love. Just what the doctor ordered for Wisconsin. Gain of 26. Here's third down. Stoddy has a man, but he's short of the first down marker. Fumagalli is bumped out by Cole Fisher.
And this is where you got to keep your cool. Doesn't matter that the clock is running. There is still plenty of time. This fourth down call is everything. Make sure everybody's on the same page. Even though the hometown faithful, you can hear some of the panic.
A lot of shifting. This is fourth and two. What are you going to do? It's like Iowa. The fifth-year senior. Here's your ball game. As of now, fourth and two. Incomplete. Was looking for Fumagalli. Cole Fisher on the coverage. And Wisconsin has turned it over on downs, out of timeouts with 36 seconds left.
And you can see the frustration. They get what they want. You knew you were going to get man-to-man coverage. You got it across the board, and you can see the route. Fumagalli is coming out. Throws a little early. Head's not around. Miscommunication. Perfect picture of what this whole entire game largely has been in the passing game. We knew it wouldn't be complicated coming in. So it can be about some exotic scheme that was going to win it. When push came to shove and it was fourth and two, you know what it was? Man's a man. And can you execute? Can you get out of your break? Can you put the ball right where you need to put it? The answer, no, for Wisconsin. And because of it, Kirk Ferentz is moving to 5-0.
It has been 5 years since Iowa won a road game against a nationally ranked team. They won in Ann Arbor, beat Michigan 38-28 on October 16th of 2010.
You'll see prettier football over the course of a season. You absolutely will. But as far as a group that's together that believes they're different than their predecessors, look out, Big Ten West. A big, huge win on the road in a place and against a team you haven't beaten since 2009. That's going to do nothing but instill a whole bunch of confidence in those Hawkeyes.
5-0 is really good looking right now. 10-6 Iowa wins. Down to Shannon Spake.
Well, Coach, it wasn't pretty, but a win is a win. What did you see out of your guys, especially in this last minute?
Well, you know, first of all, it was a pretty game. I thought it was beautiful. So any win we get is good. Coming up here is always tough. They've got an excellent team. So our guys were just, they played hard. It wasn't clean, but we played hard.